This is a recording. All right, ladies and gentlemen. So I'm doing a Zoom recording for this. I don't know how it goes. So today we will see the Taurus Lagna, the Taurus Ascendants. I've already made a video on Taurus Ascendants and how the Ascendant behaves in general, but this is a specific video on the planets. All right, so which houses do the planets rule and which house they get debilitated and which house they get exalted. So if you're new to the channel and if you're not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your ascendant or career or marriage, then you can go to my website. You will find the link of the website down in the description section. And before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So now, Taurus Lagna, rising sign. So, which is the planet which that rules a Taurus Lagna? It's Venus, of course, the sign number two. So, Venus rules the first house and the sixth house. Well, that's very funny because the Lagna Lord also rules Sadhusthana. So, this means that the ascendants, and yes, before I say anything, there are around 1/12 of the population of this entire world who are Taurus ascendants. So whatever I say in this video will not hold true for each and every ascendant of Taurus, because you will have planets in different signs and there will be conjunctions, and then most of them will be exalted or debilitated or afflicted or blessed by a benefic. All right, so if the things which I say do not match with your individual personalized horoscope, then don't worry, don't feel good, don't feel bad, because this is not a consultation for your horoscope. Okay, this is just to understand the nature of the ascendant. Okay, so Venus rules the first and the sixth house. So as I said, the Lagna Lord also rules Adhusthana house. So this shows that there's a considerable amount of homework which the ascendant has to do, which means that they can very easily run into fights sometimes, because whenever they think of themselves, which is the Lagna, the sixth house also gets activated. Because sixth house is the house of fights and quarrels and enemies. Now, what happens is the Lagna Lord gets exalted in the 11th house, because for Taurus, the 11th house has the sign Pisces, as we know. And then the Lagna Lord Venus gets debilitated in the 5th house. Now, what happens actually? Why does the Lagna Lord behave like this? Because there can be a tendency in Taurus ascendants that they always want to go to the 11th house. What is the 11th house? 11th house is our future goals and desires. Future goals means what we want to do in life. And 5th house represents who we are already. This does not mean that if we have $1 million in our account, then it's the 5th house, or if you want to have a $10 million, it's the 11th house. It's not like that. But 5th house basically shows who our soul is, what we get up in the morning for. Why do we get up in the morning? That's what the 5th house shows. So this can show that the Lagna Lord, which is the person themselves, can sometimes want to always go behind new desires instead of being satisfied or being settled with what they have already, which is there in the 5th house. And therefore the 11th house can sometimes torment them, because they can have too many desires, of course. All right, and then the 6th lord also gets exalted in the 11th house, because Venus is also the 6th lord, as we saw, and it also gets debilitated in the 5th house. So 6th lord in the 11th house getting exalted means that they can love to win over their enemies, because 11th house is the house of gains. So they may love to win over or defeat somebody. This tendency to defeat others, to prove to others that I am superior. Or not superior, but I am something at least. I am somebody at least. This can be there. Then we have Mercury. Mercury is another trinal lord. Mercury is the lord of the second house and the fifth house. And Mercury gets exalted in Virgo. So it gets exalted in the fifth house itself. And it gets debilitated in the 11th house. Wow. Because wherever Venus gets exalted, Mercury gets debilitated there. So now, the second lord gets exalted in the fifth house, although it's the fifth lord itself. So Mercury is the only planet which kind of gets exalted in his own house. That's very funny because nobody likes to give away money to anybody else. Now, what happens is Mercury gets debilitated in the 11th house, which means that when the fifth lord, which is the source of satisfaction, which is the source of our happiness, when we put it in the 11th house, what's the 11th house? It's the house of desire. Then it's not good, because for especially for this ascendant, because then desires are never ending. Desires will always keep coming and going. Sometimes they may be fulfilled, sometimes they may not be fulfilled. So obsession with desires can destroy their inner peace. And when they remain satisfied with their own self, which is the fifth house, then Mercury gets exalted there. So they remain very happy there. Now that's the precarious state of this ascendant, that the fifth lord gets exalted in the fifth house, but the Lagna lord gets exalted in the 11th house. So it's like saying, physically, at an intellectual level, when they are functioning, which is the Lagna Lord, they always want to run after new materialistic desires. But internally, the sense of satisfaction, the sense of happiness will only come when they stay with who they are, not when they are running behind materialistic pleasure. And this can also happen with their issues related to money, especially. All right, so the Lord of Money, second house, gets debilitated in the 11th house. So the more the money they have, they can feel that more, the less the money I have, actually. This can happen. And when they decide to be satisfied with how much ever money they have, which is the fifth house, then they can remain happy because the second Lord Mercury gets exalted in the fifth house. And fifth house is also creativity, creative stuff, and fifth house also shows love and affairs, yes, meeting with the opposite sex. So when that goes to the 11th house, their sense of happiness can be under challenge because they can indulge in too many affairs sometimes. All right. Then what is Moon? Moon is the lord of the third house, and Moon gets exalted in the Lagna and gets debilitated in the seventh house, because Moon gets exalted in Taurus and debilitated in Scorpio. So third lord gets exalted in the Lagna. So what this means now, Moon is what basically? Moon is generally our conception of what will give us happiness. Moon is who we are inside as a person, how we feel this world. So Taurus ascendants, they are very much feeling oriented. Feeling oriented doesn't mean they are very emotional, but they can have this desire that I want to live the way I want, not by the way others want me to live. So any planet which is in Taurus can have this feeling, and that's the reason that there can be some stubbornness also with this, because it's an art sign and it's also a fixed sign. So Moon, which shows the third house. Third house is what? Third house is our communications. Third house is our ability to negotiate. So third house also shows creativity. Third house also can show short-term encounters, acquaintances. All right. So third house basically is the house of desire, because it's the first Kama house. So when the third lord is exalted in the lagna, this can mean that there are lots and lots of desires which the person could want to fulfill. Yes, and we have also seen earlier that the lagna lord gets exalted in another kama house, which is the 11th house. So now third lord gets exalted in the lagna. This means that they are very adamant about fulfilling their desires by the way they want, because this is the moon. Moon shows who they are. Now it gets debilitated in the seventh. It means that they do not like to hear what others have to say regarding their desires. So if you meet a Taurus Lagna person and you tell him or her that, oh, you are desiring this, maybe this is not that great or good or bad, then they may not like that. All right. So they want that they should be happy according to their own terms. And the fun part is, whatever they desire, they think sometimes is correct, because Lagna is the self and third house is the house of desire. And they can have many friends. They can have too many friends also. They can have too many acquaintances. They can have too much passion for writing, creativity and such stuff also, because the third house also shows all those things. And third house can also at times show sexual encounters which are not legitimate, or very short term sexual encounters, because eighth house is the house of prostitution and third house is the eighth from the eighth house. So if moon is afflicted and the overall chart is damaged, and if Venus is also spoiled, then it can happen that Taurus ascendants, because the third lord gets exalted in the lagna, they can run into too many such encounters. Okay, that can happen at times. Of course, this is not a blanket statement, as I said. So it will depend on your horoscope. I gave the conditions. So if you have moon exalted in the lagna, then don't think that you are like that. And yes, they can look very good because of, if moon is exalted in the lagna, because the first house gives the appearance, all right? And because Venus also rules the first house, so because of that, they're very much focused on luxury and looking good, all the beautiful scents, the fragrant substances, they can be addicted to all those things like deodorants and, you know, makeup, etc. They can have addictions pertaining to drinking, or they can like to drink any liquid in general, not alcohol specifically, but anything in general. They can like to drink milkshake, etc. also. Because moon also gets exalted in the lagna, so that thing with liquids is always there. And they love to be around ladies, because moon and Venus are both feminine planets. So they love to be around ladies sometimes, I've seen. And they also love to be discussing about things like relationships, love and romance and family, etc. All these things. Now, Sun is ruling the fourth house and it gets exalted in the 12th house. And it gets debilitated in the sixth house. This is a very interesting placement. So this shows that Sun, which is the conception of the self, Sun is the original Karaka for the first house. So Sun at times can behave like the Lagna Lord. So on one hand, the Lagna Lord gets exalted in the 11th and Sun gets exalted in the 12th house. So this can show that although physically, the person can love to indulge in desires, which is the 11th house. But when it comes to fulfillment of the soul, what the soul identifies itself with in this material realm, they can be more happy when they let go of certain things. Okay, so for Taurus ascendants, the best lesson is that we do not run too much after materialistic things. And whenever required, we let go of certain attachments which we have. Because Sun gets debilitated in the sixth house, which is the house of struggle. So they can have this tendency at times, if Sun is afflicted or badly placed for Taurus Lagna people, that they can surrender sometimes before even the battle begins. But that doesn't happen most of the times because Venus, the Lagna Lord, also rules the sixth. All right, so it's a very tricky situation here. And yes, they can have tendencies of escapism sometimes because Sun gets exalted there. So by escaping, sometimes they can have a lot of fulfillment of their ego, or they can make claims that I am very detached. These kind of things can happen. Then we see that Mars rules the seventh house because the sign Scorpio is in the seventh, and Mars also rules the 12th house. So because of this, Taurus ascendants, the first relationship which they encounter, because the first relationship comes from the seventh house. So the first primary or prominent relationship which they encounter, because the sign Scorpio is there, and Scorpio is also co-ruled by Ketu. So it can happen that they can have too many vulnerabilities there, too much sexuality can be there, or they can be controlled by fear regarding that. All right. And there can be some losses on those lines. But the Lord of the seventh, Mars, gets exalted in the ninth house and it gets debilitated in the third house. So now the seventh Lord gets exalted in the ninth. This means what? That whenever they make their marriage more spiritual rather than the third house, which is the house of enjoyment, then it's great for the sustenance of the marriage. Why? I'm saying because the seventh Lord is also the 12th Lord. All right. So 12th Lord getting exalted in the ninth can show great spiritual progress after marriage if linked with the seventh house, which it is in this case. And third house, as we know, is the house of desire. So there Mars gets debilitated. All right. So seventh Lord getting debilitated in the third, which means that when the focus of the marriage goes to just for mundane materialistic enjoyment, primarily sensual enjoyment, then the marriage can be in doldrums. All right. So for them, it's recommended that both the husband and the wife, they do spiritual practices together, because the ninth house shows spiritual practices. They meet the guru time to time. They chant mantras every day, read scriptures like the Srimad Bhagavatam or Gita or Bible or Quran, whichever they want. That's it. And then Jupiter is the Lord of the 8th house and it's the Lord of the 11th house. So Jupiter and Mars have been marked in red here because they are dire malefics for this Lagna. Because now, of course, I mean, Jupiter is the arch rival of Venus, because Jupiter shows spiritual happiness and materialistic pleasure is shown by Venus. So that is why he doesn't like to stay in the ascendant of Libra and Taurus, because that is why he becomes a Dustana Lord. For Libra, he rules the third and the sixth. Now, for Taurus Lagna people, Jupiter rules the eighth house and he also rules the 11th house. So now, opposite of Mars, Jupiter gets exalted in the third house and Jupiter gets debilitated in the ninth house. Why this happens? Because what Jupiter is, Jupiter ultimately wants that you progress spiritually, but that doesn't match well with the goal of this ascendant, you see, because the goal of the ascendant is materialistic pleasure, because that's ruled by Venus. Therefore, the exaltation of Jupiter in the third house can show that there is a lot of homework which is to be done by the native. So it's like saying, when you go to the guru you don't like, because Jupiter in the ninth can show a great guru, but it gets debilitated there. So it can show that you do not like gurus, or it can show that you do not like spiritual wisdom. That can also be shown from here. And instead, you like materialistic pleasure very much. So Jupiter represents spiritual progress along with material prosperity. So this can show that The Taurus Lagna people can have a tendency to go to God only for materialistic reasons, materialistic boons, materialistic benedictions, to fulfill their needs of the third house, which is their desires, so that their Jupiter gets exalted. So Taurus Lagna people, I have seen sometimes that unless there is a calamity in their life, which means there's something which they like or they love very much is taken away from them, they do not turn to God sometimes, because Jupiter rules the eighth house of sudden reversals and transformations. And then what happens? Then they will temporarily look to God, but if they again get that thing back or anything new, then they can again have this tendency to forget God. All right. So that's a very difficult scenario for Jupiter, that it gets exalted in the house of desire, which is originally the house of Gemini. So the lesson for these people in matters of Jupiter is that they should learn to cultivate a relationship with the Guru, and they should learn to go to God irrespective of their material situations. All right. And then Saturn I have marked in black, like Venus, I mean in bold, if you see here. Why I have done that? Because Venus is the Lagnesh, but Saturn is the Yoga Karaka. Yoga Karaka means, for any ascendant, if a planet rules a Kendra and a Trikon simultaneously, then it becomes a Yog Karak. So for Taurus Lagna people, Saturn rules the ninth house, which is a trine, 159, and Kendras are 14, 710. So it also rules the 10th house. So that is why it's a Yoga Karaka. Yoga Karaka means one who adds to the chart. Adds means in a good way, depending on the placement, of course. Yoga is addition, and Karaka means one who performs the activity, doer basically. So Saturn gets exalted in the 6th house, and Saturn gets debilitated in the 12th house. So when it comes to matters of career and religion, because 9th house shows religion and our spiritual beliefs, and 10th house can show our desire in life primarily, what we want to become ultimately. 10th house is what happens ultimately to us. It's not the time of death basically, but as we say, Mahatma Gandhi was this, whoever. So that depends on that 10th house, how people perceive us. So 10th Lord and 9th Lord gets exalted in the 6th house of quarrel, disputes, enemies. So this shows that wherever they are, a primary karma of their life can be in dealing with their enemies. 6th house is basically weakness. So when 9th Lord gets exalted in the 6th house, it means that whenever they are doing spiritual practices, it can help them to overcome their weaknesses very fast. All right. And it gets debilitated in the 12th house. So instead of just escaping into things like, you know, alcohol, addiction, and all such stuff, they should work on their weaknesses. All right. If they do not work on their weaknesses, then things can get difficult. So for Taurus ascendants, it's highly essential that they be realistic, be grounded, and they do not run after, and they just don't, should not run away from their problems in life. Instead, they should focus on solving the issues which they are having basically, because 6th house is the house of our inner weakness. Then Rahu rules Aquarius, which is actually the 10th house, but I've made a mistake here. I've given 11. So the sign Aquarius is in the 10th house. And they say that Rahu gets exalted in the sign of Taurus and in Gemini also. So Taurus is first house and Gemini is the second house. And it gets debilitated in the opposite, 7th Scorpio and 8th Sagittarius. So Rahu gets exalted in the ascendant. Why does Rahu gets exalted there? Because Rahu is basically our desires. So they feel very happy sometimes when they become more and more and more desirous of materialistic things. And Ketu, which is the planet of separation, can have the opposite effects. Okay, because Ketu rules the sign of Scorpio, which is in their seventh house. And it gets exalted in Scorpio itself. Some say that it gets exalted in Sagittarius also, and it gets debilitated in Taurus and Gemini, because now when Ketu gets debilitated in the Lagna, what it means? It means that Ketu, which is the planet of spirituality and moksha, is not very well handled by this ascendant. Because when Ketu is in Taurus, it shows that we are not able to cope up when there is separation from things related to Taurus. But suppose Ketu is in Sagittarius, then we can see the higher vision, Sagittarius or Scorpio at least. So this can show that the experience of losing something can be very painful to them, because this debilitation happens in the Lagna itself. All right. And whenever anything is fulfilled, their mind gets bloated with extra load of pleasure, because Rahu gets exalted there. All right. So this is how we study the ascendant and the planets for Taurus Lagna. And let me stop the screen share. Okay. So I hope I could do some justice to Taurus Lagna people. And as I said earlier, this is not a consultation for your Lagna, because this will vary as per your ascendant and your placement of Venus and Sun and Moon and the entire horoscope. So if anything which I said here doesn't apply to you, please do not take it personally. All right. So if you want a consultation regarding your chart, then you can go to my website down in the description section. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up and share it with somebody who is also a Taurus Lagna. Okay. God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. I will stop the recording now. Bye-bye. See you.